Welcome to Outdoor Ohio. We're putting the camera on a group of bunnies from Knox County as they take me along on a hunt for cottontail rabbits. For the past 10 to 15 years, every Saturday from November through the end of February, there's a group of orange-clad hunters and a whole pack of lively beagles looking for an elusive little brown mammal in a fence row or thicket. We set out around 8 o'clock in the morning and headed to a private farm south of Mount Vernon. Once we got there, there was no waiting around. The dogs were quickly out of the truck, and the bunny hunt was underway. We dive right in, spreading out the hunters, kicking the bushes, and helping the dogs get a fresh start on the scent trail of a rabbit.
Yeah, what we like to do is when we go up to them on a flower rose bush, rabbits really enjoy that type of habitat. Sometimes it kind of helps the dogs to get them moving. The dogs can't hit every prowl in here, so a lot of times we just like to help the dogs out a little bit and get the rabbits moving.
Which in cover like this didn't take very long.
Well, bell's fired up. There goes one. There goes, there goes, there goes. There goes, there goes, there goes. Yeah, 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 yeah. There bell, there bell. We're right behind it. Here, bell, there he is. There he is, bell. Get him.
That rabbit's gone deep in this bush. So good track. Track's laying well. Should come back around up to there or over to Denny pretty quickly here.
Andy has been rabbit hunting for years, so I asked him how he could be so sure where that rabbit was going to end up.
They typically make a circle, and he started there, so he'll either come around and complete the circle, or he'll come back and try and cut those dogs off and go right back where he started.
It looks like Andy was right. While young payment plan the puppy looks on, Denny sees what the dogs are chasing.
Come on, payment plan, come here.
That is payment plan.
Yeah, that's
his puppy. Yeah. Come here, come here, come here, come here, come here, come here, come here.
Come, yeah, you're gonna get wet.
Come here, come here, come here.
It's important to let the dogs know they did well. So we give the dogs a chance to, in essence, catch up with the rabbit, give it a sniff, and move on for the next one.
Pick that rabbit up and take it right to him. He's sniffing around on. I think he knows what he's sniffing right there. That's right where he came across.
Come here, come here, come here. Ah, there you go. Come here, come here. Look, look, look. This is it. This is it. This is it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it.
Good job, payment plan.
This is my brother, Michael. We've been hunting together for at least 20, 30 years. It's kind of a family tradition. We kind of got started on Thanksgiving. We always go out on a family hunt Thanksgiving morning. And it just kind of grew into something we liked. It's good exercise, and we enjoy going out with the guys. We normally get a group together every Saturday morning and go out for a nice hunt. We normally run 6 or 7 beagles, which is more than you actually need. Sometimes that works against it, but we just enjoy listening to the dogs run, and when they all finally get together and get into tune, it is enjoyable to go out and just listen to them run. We've been doing this for a long time. It's getting more and more difficult to find good places to hunt, so we try to not hit places more than one time per year. We were nice enough to have a farmer bring us down below Mount Vernon today into some real good territory here. This is ideal rabbit country. Very rare to find a place this good.
And good it was. And now this time, I was in the hot spot.
That ain't so hard. Even an amateur. Here, dogs. There he is, here he is.
Once again, the hunting is as much for the dogs as it is for us. So I need to let them catch up with their reward so they know it's okay to look for another one. And that didn't take long either.
Did you get a whiff?
Chris Chris had kicked one up, and the dogs actually saw it head into the brush and were in hot pursuit.
That was good. Dogs will run, grab it up ahead, bring it in a nice big loop, and most of the times that rabbit will come right back on the same path that he went out on. I think the rabbit knows if it can get on its own scent trail, it stands a better chance of losing the dogs. If it keeps circling around in its own self, the dogs will eventually get confused and lose it. A lot of the times when that rabbit circles around on itself, the track will actually overlay itself and the dogs will go in a circle and they'll actually realize that that rabbit has gone in a circle and then gone off in another place, and they have to try and find where that rabbit went out, or it could have gone in a hole, in which case the dogs will give it up. Well, this is a prime example. That rabbit came up where the dogs were, turned right back around, went right back out the same trail that he came in on. Now the dogs have to go back and pick up where he went out.
The dogs weren't ready to give up this chase, but the rabbit had outsmarted them, running around in circles, seemingly several times. It was up to Chris to help them get back on track.
Sometimes dogs need a little bit of help. If you see where the rabbit came in and went back, you can point them in the right direction, they'll pick it back up like they've done. Periodically, the rabbit doesn't want to cooperate, and he'll go out ahead, and he'll make his loop out ahead of you, and he'll sit there, you know, 100 yards up ahead, and just keep making his loop up there. And eventually, you have to move forward to get into that rabbit's loop.
So if you're looking for a great way to spend a lazy afternoon, look no further than the cottontail rabbit. They hide really well, they're really fun to hunt whether you have dogs or not.
That's what we're at.
And it doesn't take long to fill that bag of four, which will make a great meal for your family. We'll see you next time on Outdoor Ohio.